Feminism may have changed many things, but a vast majority of women still take their husband's surname after marriage. Australian man Grant Phillips has bucked the trend, though, adopting his bride's last name when they got married.
This week, the TV producer opened up about his decision, telling women.com.au it was not a sacrifice, but an honour. So, in this age of gender equality, should more men be taking their wife's last name upon tying the knot?
We'll discuss this. We're joined by another man who's taken his wife's surname, Matthew Broberg from Portland in the United States, and in Canberra, journalist Suzanne Mostyn, who kept her maiden name, and in Sydney, social researcher Mark McCrindle, who kept his bachelor name. Morning to you all. Thanks for joining us this morning.
Morning.
Matthew, let's start with you. You were born Matthew Brenda, but when you got married this year, you became Matthew Broberg. Why did you make this decision to take your wife's last name?
I did, yes. Yeah. So when it came down to it, it was a bit of a simple logic at the base of it that I always thought of my wife and I having the same surname after getting married, and she had never considered changing hers. So in that situation, the only conclusion was that we were going to take hers. So it was kind of simple at first. It, of course, gets more complicated when you talk it out, but at the base level, that's it.
What about your friends, your family? What did they think of this? They think it was odd that you were going to change your name?
It certainly bucked a little bit of a trend. We're no different in the U.S. that majority of women change their last name, and men rarely do. But when it came to my friends and family, they all know me and know that I'm not scared of doing something a little different. And since I wrote about it, I wrote it with the intention of explaining why and how we came to that decision. So once people read it, they were all on board and I'd say like heavily in favor of it and proud of me for doing so.
Okay, let's go to Suze now. Suze, good morning to you. Why did you choose to keep your surname after marriage, and I should say, the partner of our great political editor, Mark Riley?
Yeah, well, for about 5 minutes, I thought about McMarried face, but, you know, it didn't sound really great, did it? Look, if it ain't broke, why fix it? And I've got a strong sense of identity, and I'd worked really hard to build a professional calling card, and I really just didn't want that being completely erased. I love Riles madly, but he didn't really expect me to change my name, and although I've got to say, it didn't come without some complication. We had our first son when Mark was New York correspondent in newspapers, and we registered in the hospital, you know, mother, Suzanne Mostyn, father, Mark Riley, and then sometime later we got two bills, one for baby Mostyn, one for baby Riley, both named James Hudson, born at exactly the same time, in exactly the same birthing suite, and, you know, it took weeks and weeks and weeks for us to convince them that it wasn't two separate babies, because they just couldn't understand that if we were married, you know, how was it that I hadn't changed my name? You're married, why don't you have Mr. Riley's name? Aren't you Mrs. Riley? You know, it was very confusing for them.
It's a really personal decision for women. I understand your point. Do you think it is more empowering for women to keep their maiden name?
Look, it's entirely personal, and our names are, you know, a deeply identifying thing. So, and for women around the world, it's been sort of a thing that you must change your name. For some, it's a radical act to say, no, I'm going to keep my own name. And, you know, I think it's interesting that society is always influenced by, you know, the way things are modelled by parents, by friends, social media and celebrities. And, you know, the actress in Avatar, Zoe Saldana, her husband's an artist, Marco, and he took her name, and even the children have her name, which I think is a wonderful thing. And maybe people like, you know, the previous guest and also Zoe, it might actually be a springboard for other men to do the same. I think it's a wonderful thing for a man to take her name. It's a good thing.
Mark, let's bring you in here now. Where does the tradition of taking the husband's name come from, and how evolved over the years?
Well, it does go back many hundreds of years to more patriarchal times, when it was almost unquestioned that a woman would take on the husband's name. But we've certainly seen a lot of change across Western Europe. People keep their names for life, even if socially they might take on a spouse's name. We see across China the tradition of changing a name is not done. Russia, not as much done. And in the Spanish-speaking world, people adopt a mother's name and a father's name and retain that. But it does come back to children coming into the equation. And if people keep their own names, you can go for the the double-barrelled surname, but then what if those children that are double-barrelled marry a double-barrelled child as well? You know, what happens there? So that's part of the reason that there has been taking on one name or the other. Australia is pretty conservative in this whole approach, though, with more than 80% of brides taking on the groom surname and about 10% of women maintaining their own name. That's growing, particularly as women study later, have more education, get established in their careers longer before getting married. There's more challenge in changing one's name from a professional perspective.
Mm. OK, Matthew, Mrs. Rolls and Mark, thank you very much for all of that.
Bye.
Thank you all.
Yep.